Nike check, t-shirt check, sneakers check, socks check, hoodie check, shorts check, Nike check.
I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. The shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Get the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it.
First opened way back in 1924, but renovated in 2002. There's a look inside Venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Just a short time ago, this crowd loud enough to shake the foundations of this nearly century-old building. They are ready for football indeed in Chicago as their guys get set to do battle with the Minnesota Vikings. The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Stick on first and 10. He's got his 6'5 receiver. That's Tim Patrick. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 13 yards on the game's opening play.
First and 10 at the 38-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. A shotgun throw for Stick. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for his rookie Cole Kmet that time. But it'll be second down. And that one off the mark behind him. Incomplete. They work again from the 38 on second and 10. Stick from the gun. Miller with first down and more. He completes this into the hands of Miller. So a pretty early first quarter roughing the passer penalty.
Seems like the officials are going to let everyone know they're taking charge of this game. They're always going to protect the quarterback.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. Here's Stick looking to throw. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Stick looks to throw it again. Flushed out right. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
On third down, it's Stick. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that is caught. That one. He reeled it in one-handed for a touchdown.
That's all.
A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. His guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Kaepernick now on first down. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack.
Well, CD, you know, so often we talk about quarterbacks holding on to the ball too long. Well, we can't say that there. He had no time to do much of anything.
And this came from the edge. And those pass rushers, they have so many tricks of the trade to get around blockers. They have a lot of tools in their kit. This was pure speed and athleticism on this play, though. And they could barely get a glove on it before he got the quarterback on the ground.
As we check the next-gen stats, you'll see he had precious little time to do anything with the football there.
That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down. Carry for the Boise State Bronco, Alexander Madison. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to convert on third and short yardage with a gain of four. A gain of four that time as the drive continues. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now a play fake. Kaepernick. Flushed it, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down.
Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
5 yards that time, taking it himself, and he has enough for the first.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
A couple of first downs on the drive already, as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. They'll run with Madison, and they'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackle through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. Oh, an absolutely filthy juke. He's got some space now. And finally down at the 9-yard line. It's a big one there for the Vikings. 46 yards. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. They'll run it with Madison. And the Vikings are going to have it first and goal as they'll take this down to about the 3. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, that he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me football. And that's what they're all about. Continuity.
He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
B.C. Johnson, his second touchdown on the season. And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Dan Bailey to kick off for Minnesota.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
at the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tumble.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. They'll run it for the first time with Williams. And a 42-yard line here and brought down there. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Now stick. And it's complete. It's Damian Williams. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 16 yards is the pickup there and a first down for Chicago.
First and 10 at the 41-yard line.
These two teams all tied after one.
With the score tied 7-7.
First and 10, stick. They'll find Miller, that's complete. And he's taken down inside the 30. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Stick looking to throw on first and 10. He rifles one that's intercepted. William Jackson with a pick. And he returns it here to his own 18-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on-the-job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense going to have to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Second down, eluding the pressure right. This to C.J. Ham, the fullback. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Kaepernick now on first down. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So that'll back him up five. Yeah. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. Running from the shotgun with Madison. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
16 at the 40-yard line.
Here's Madison. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle, and that's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
It's Kaepernick. Open man here is Conklin. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Zone now. Kaepernick escaping the pressure right. And he'll be forced out of bounds shy of the line of scrimmage, so that'll be credited as a sack. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Push his way down to about the 14. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Dancing to his left. Brings up fourth down. Solid coverage by the Bears D.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the football trying to find ones to get you into the end zone and get you six?
The Bears take over first and 10.
The Bears' offense ready to go for their next drive. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 13 yards as they've got the connection working. His second catch in a row, first down. And he'll be taken down at the 34. Alex Smith there on the tackle.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
And oh, it'll be intercepted.
A great read, and it's picked off.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Smith catches left side. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A big play that time through the air. 36 yards.
First down, Minnesota.
So they are going to call on Dan Bailey here. His career long is 56 yards done in Seattle. This will be spotted just shy of midfield. A 59-yard attempt. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short. No good. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
The Vikings have to like their position. They've got the lead. They get this football as well as we are back and underway for the second half. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
First down, Kaepernick. Pressure, and he's taken down. What a big sack. Khalil Mack in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
And that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football. Led to a sack. That's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
On second down, this is Madison. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
The Bears bring out an extra defender in the secondary now for third down. From the gun, it's Kaepernick. Khalil Mack, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. The Vikings send out their punter, and surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. Agnew now to return. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time, and the Bears take over.
At their own 37-yard line.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
They turned the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here. Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now, hotly contested in the third quarter. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked up by Mike Hughes. Boy, so another interception, CD. And it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
So after the INT, it's Kaepernick. Throw left side complete. It's Smith. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. That catch good for only a couple.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. They fake the give. Now Kaepernick. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Smith. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another 1st down. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. And now he's going to use a Kaepernick hit. Fumble. He lost the football. And this is picked up by the Bears. And he returns it here to his own 18-yard line.
All I know, partners, that with every play call that came in, there was a little discussion about, hey, we can seal this bad boy. We can really put ourselves in a great spot to take total control. And yet they find a way to cough it up.
Yeah, the 2-score game opportunity eludes them, and now a chance for the other side to come back here.
Yeah, that means defense has to go out there and make some plays themselves. So we call sudden change. Let's see if the defense is mentally ready to take care of it.
Call it a gain of 5, and that'll make it 2nd down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Stick. And for the 4th time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 40. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
And it's up and good.
Makes the score Vikings 17, Bears 7.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Bears' offense ready to go for their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. I had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. On 2nd and 10, it's Stick. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Miller. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And he will have a 1st down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Give him the 3rd down conversion. 5 yards on the play.
1st and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Here's Stick on 1st and 10. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Robinson. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number 3. Back now at Soldier Field. It's Bears football, but they trail on the scoreboard as we get set to bring you the 4th quarter. On 2nd down, Williams. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a 1st down. Now, yes, a 2-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on 2nd and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the 1st down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a 2-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 16 yards is the pickup there, and a 1st down for Chicago. Stick from the gun. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Robinson. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last 2 plays. So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete. Allen Robinson, the intended receiver. That'll bring up 2nd down.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think the part of their plan was to hit him over the top with the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Stick. It's caught on the right side. Williams. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be 3rd and less than a yard. So 3rd and inches, and this will be the 9th play of the drive. They'll run out of the gun here. Williams. And he gets the 1st yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. Just a gain of 1 yard, but it's going to set him up with a 1st and goal. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Cole Kmet, the intended receiver, but it'll be 2nd and goal.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's 2nd and goal now. A shotgun throw for Stick. Buying time, and he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Easton Stick with touchdown number 15 of the year and 2nd of the game. And the Bears draw a bit closer.
I'd have to say that for him, that was an all-encompassing drive because it was his arm that got his team down to that point, but his legs that finished the deal. Give him credit for making it happen.
Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
Yeah! Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Now, Charles, of course, you got to remember, last possession they fumbled. It led to a touchdown. One score game here. Got to be careful.
And this is where coaching and training really comes into play, doesn't it? What does everyone say after an error? Next play. Move on. Next drive. That mantra has to come to the front. They've got to take care of business right here and act like the last series just didn't happen.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. On the handoff, it's Madison. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Out of the backfield, he was trying to get that to Alexander Madison, but it's going to be second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
They'll try to run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And once again, he's going to be stopped up behind the line. Second straight play. Shades of the 85 Bear defense a little bit.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. And he will find his big tight end over the middle. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Another carry now for Madison. And a short gain here down to the 22.
The Viking ball carrier, Chase Winovich, brought him down. 1 yard gain brings up second.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They face a second down, but they are in field goal range. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
Now Kaepernick. And he's got his tight end. That's Smith. And the Vikings are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Going to try to sneak it, and he is over the line for another rushing touchdown.
Is he a quarterback or is he a tailback?
Colin Kaepernick, his second TD of the game and 18th of the year, and the Vikings are going to widen that advantage, and his kick is right through.
Vikings 24, Bears 14. Dan Bailey to kick off for Minnesota.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Jamal Agnew now to return it. And we've got a penalty marker down here as he's able to get this only to the 20-yard line. Well, that holding call set him up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
Here's Stick looking to throw. Finding the end open man, and that's Tim Patrick. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try and throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
To throw on second and 10. Stick, and that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Well, you won't hear any boos from this home crowd on that call.
No, not at all. And it's been a long day for this crowd. Waiting for this game has been a long evening as well. Finally, they feel they got a call.
It's caught on the right side by Robinson. They'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
First down. First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Stick looks to throw it again. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Mike Hughes.
And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, 5 interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a 5th interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and find another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down.
A gain of 4. It's now 2nd and 6.
So the final seconds have ticked away in this Minnesota victory. And I know I'm not breaking any news when I say that any road win in this league is a good one.
No doubt.
But it's a double bonus when you get a victory on the road in your division.
And when you start a season, each team breaks down their schedule in different ways. Some do it every 4 games, right? Let's go quarterly. Others say, listen, we've got to take care of our home field. And, you know, out of a 16-game season, if you get 8 at home, let's at least win 7 at home and split our road games. That's what you're trying to get done. So you're exactly right. A road win, precious, especially within the division.
So for the Vikings, they inch closer to respectability now at 3-6 on the year. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Dallas Cowboys. Meanwhile, for the Bears, they're going the wrong way, as this will drop them to 3-7 now on the year. And they'll get a late bye next week, which might be coming at the right time. And they'll be back in action in week 12. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
Granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. 2 seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins in the world suspended. I told them what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top once again. Yeah. Ay, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end.
Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was popped, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in, I've been on 10-10 since. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he falling again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with it, so what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Hey. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the air. Now we on 10, 10, 10.
No, but I'm on this every day.